It's kind of a pinch me moment that we're actually getting to make this movie.
Jim, 13, 14 years ago, had a dream where Pandora came to him.
He's the director and the writer and the inventor.
This is cool.
He's taking you on this journey that it's beyond words.
Run! Definitely run!
This is his place. Call it Planet Jim.
You're not gonna believe where I am.
I wrote Treatment in 95, and it had all the characters in it and creatures and settings, but at the time, it turned out that it wasn't possible to do what I wanted to do.
Jim talks about that he had to wait for technology to catch up to this script that he had written.
So I just literally put the project in a drawer, forgot about it.
In 2005, Jim said, I think we're close enough where if we could push the technology and tell this story that we always wanted to tell.
I got it out and dusted it off and read it and said, you know, that's not too bad a story. I bet that would make a pretty good movie. That'd make a movie that I'd want to go see.
We've been in cryo for 5 years, 9 months, and 22 days.
Jake's on a really interesting journey. He's paralyzed from the waist down. He's confined to a wheelchair.
He's a wounded former Marine.
And he's granted the opportunity to go fill in for his brother that was working on a planet called Pandora.
Your brother represented a significant investment.
Since your genome is identical to his, you could step into his shoes.
Navitar is a remotely controlled body, which is the DNA of the alien, DNA of me mixed together. You're placed into a link.
Marching.
And my thoughts and personality channeled into a synthetically grown Navitar. Pandora is a place of opportunity. I think he's come there for an adventure.
So you just figured you'd come out here to the most hostile environment known to man and see how it went?
I figured it's just another hellhole.
We were creating an entire world from scratch. So you get a number of world-class artists. I mean, really the top people, the people that, you know, I'm an artist, so I wanted to find people that impressed me.
This wasn't like a world that he was making up. It was something he had seen and now it's reporting back to us.
I think he's been there, he wrote a travelogue about it, and he brought it back for us to recreate.
He created this entire environment, the creatures, a different language.
Try and use big words.
This culture.
That's, I think, one of the great things about Avatar is it's not just a movie, it's a universe.
The number of animals, the number of creatures, the number of vehicles, it just doesn't have a precedent.
This is great.
But we also knew that what we were about to do was significantly beyond what had already been done. Because not only did we want absolute reality in terms of human performance as it was created by our actors, but we had to do it for a large number of characters.
My brother, Skrinet, with me!
The most exciting thing is, it is my performance. This thing walks and talks and acts like me.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
One of the things that I'm always gonna take with me is the fact that I was a part of a revolutionary experience in Hollywood.
We were always trying to push the envelope. This time we were trying to push the envelope and it pushed back. And then we pushed harder. And it took a long time because it doesn't look like anything you've seen before.
You should see your faces.